the Hyrax has been taken to the vents. His tusk is twisting inwards, and if left, would become increasingly painful and affect his ability to eat. In order to be treated, he needs to be put under anesthetic. Vet Zoe has never anesthetized a rock Hyrax before, and there's very little information out there about how to go about it, so she's devising her own technique.
We've got a dose that tells us how to sedate a guinea pig. We're going to use half of that dose initially and see how he responds to that. If that's enough to get him to the point where we can handle him, put a mask on his face with some gas, then we'll do that. If it's not, then we'll give him a top up. We'll bring the moving side in, we'll just hold him against this edge here, and then the idea is that we give this into a muscle. Brilliant. So, now we just have to wait.
5 minutes later, and the dose seems to have been sufficient to put him under.
Okay, so he's looking like the sedation's had a pretty good effect. We just need to get him on some oxygen now. And then start with a cautious little poke test, which he's not reacting to.
Zoe's confident the patient is sufficiently sedated.
So we'll give him a little bit of oxygen for a minute. Now it's really important when we anaesthetise any animal, but particularly the small ones, that we keep them warm while they're asleep. They'll lose an awful lot of heat once they're anaesthetised. So we use this space blanket like runners use. We'll also cover him up with a heated blanket. So I'm just having a look. We can see on this side that this is the tusk that's growing abnormally, and it is actually getting in the way for him, so it's starting to press on his lower jaw there. If we weren't to get this back to a more normal length, it will just carry on growing, and it would grow in through his skin and cause all sorts of trouble. In the wild, he wouldn't be able to survive with this because he wouldn't be able to eat. So I think what we'll do at the moment is just remove that long portion of the tusk and see how he copes with that once he's at home. Brings it back to a more normal length and shape for him, which hopefully means he'll be able to now eat much more comfortably. So this type of tooth is a constantly erupting tooth. Their teeth are designed to erupt for their whole life, so those teeth don't have a pulp cavity like we do, and so it means that you can just cut them open if they overgrow, and there's no sensitive part in the middle there.
It's now an anxious wait while Muttley comes round from the anaesthetic.
I would say any anaesthetic, the induction and the recovery are the two high-risk times. So what we need to do is be really careful and keep a very close eye on him while he's recovering. Once he's up, and normally we would look for them to be lifting up their head, you know, ultimately standing and walking around. Once he's doing that, then he's out of the woods. Right, we'll pop him back in.
Thankfully, after a few moments, Muttley regains consciousness. But Vet Zoe is concerned that he may require further treatment.
It may have been that he had a short-term discomfort in the mouth that he was avoiding that's led to this, but we really need to keep a close eye on him, because if that's something that's going to recur, then we need to be doing this procedure, you know, potentially every 6 months or so for him.
So, just like us, regular dental checkups should keep Muttley in good health.